Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Last week, I made a video talking about early release copies of Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. There were plenty of images circling the internet, people getting early copies from various places, whether that was GameStop, Best Buy, getting it through mom and pop shops. People were getting physical copies of Black Ops Cold War. And at the time, I had put a PSA out there mentioning, be careful, we might start seeing some campaign leaks, we might start seeing some zombie leaks, and we might start seeing some leaks for the multiplayer. However, something very interesting happened. None of that happened. In fact, there's no way possible right now for people to leak the game. And that's simply because campaign is locked, multiplayer is locked, and zombies is locked. Right now, if you boot up the game in an offline session, the only thing you have available is a multiplayer with bots on a few different maps that we saw in the beta, and a few different pre-made classes, and you can't customize your own class. This is crazy to see this happening because right now nothing can be spoiled. What we do know is preload is available on the PlayStation. It's going to be available in a couple of days for Blizzard, and once that happens and people start data mining, they'll start seeing more from the campaign, they'll start seeing assets from the game, and obviously they'll start maybe seeing Easter egg steps for zombies, so be careful for that. But as we stand, it's in a situation where people can't access it normally by just simply booting up the game. Even if you own a disc copy of the game, you can't just simply boot it up and go into private matches and play the campaign. That's not possible right now. It requires a patch in order to unlock the campaign, in order to unlock the multiplayer, and to unlock the zombies mode. And this of course poses a question, and I'd like to know what y'all think about it down below in the comments section, so of course join the conversation there. But my question is, what is stopping Activision and Treyarch from keeping those locks on campaign and zombies for the time being? Of course, putting the servers online and getting people booted up into multiplayer, you know, people are going to rank up early anyway. But keeping those critical locations locked until the global release date, I think that's entirely possible for this franchise to do, and I don't know if they're going to do it. With Blizzard actually putting their preload up on PC, people are going to be digging through the files like we said before, and there's a possibility that certain things are spoiled that way. From a gameplay perspective, it would honestly be pretty cool to see those pieces of the game locked until everyone has access to it. Multiplayer is a situation where I don't know if that's going to be possible, specifically because when those servers go online, they don't want to be hammered. They want to be able to have people ease into it, making sure that they're running in general, there's no hiccups whatsoever. That way, when the big green button goes live, then boom, everyone can join in and there shouldn't be any hiccups whatsoever. But we're talking about a Call of Duty launch. Millions upon millions of people are going to be hopping in at once, even though, you know, the game is dead, right? Like everyone always says that. There are a couple of new things that have been found though in the offline mode. Like right now, there's some footage circulating the internet, which I cannot show you. I'll get a huge copyright strike. There's footage of weapon inspects being shown. Instead of it actually being bound to a button and holding that button down, it's actually in the wheel where you would put a gesture in Modern Warfare or a spray. I find that kind of fascinating because this opens up the possibility of them doing unique weapon gestures. And that's the second half of the conversation that I want to have in this video. Would you be against unique weapon gestures? This is something that we saw predominantly with Call of Duty World War II. Specific blueprint variants would allow specific gestures, and each one of them were unique in their own way. Obviously, on a base weapon, you're just going to do the standard gesture, but in World War II, you could look at the weapon, and sometimes you'd pull the magazine out, sometimes you'd do a gesture with your hand. Either way, this would blow it wide open, having a unique gesture that can be attached to any specific weapon and allowing you to put that into the wheel. You could do multiple gestures with the same weapon if you had multiple versions of it. When we talk about how that can impact the game itself, we already know that there's going to be a Modern Warfare-like shop. We already know that the Battle Pass is going to be coming back. I think that this would just add new and varying items aside from, you know, calling cards and emblems that we can see along the way. Having unique gestures and having unique emotes to do in-game would totally make sense. And when we talk about the scope that is Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War, there's a lot to see and do. I'm excited for zombies. I'm excited for multiplayer. I'm definitely excited for the campaign, knowing now that it's a continuation to the original Black Ops. There's just so much, and I don't know. I did a little poll over on Twitter, by the way, and if you don't follow me, I'll put a link down below in the description. We talk about a lot of different stuff in regard to games, and of course I tweet when my videos go live, so if you happen to not get your notifications here on YouTube, make sure to check out the Twitter account. So I asked everybody, what do you plan on playing first when it comes to Black Ops Cold War? A little over 17,000 votes so far. There's a couple days left if you wanted to get in on this poll. Zombies is currently in the lead, surprisingly. Multiplayer not far behind it, and then of course campaign with 25% of the votes. Campaign, generally speaking, is one of those modes that I hop into. I tend to find the game a couple of days early when it's about to come out, and I usually tackle campaign first, but it seems like this year is going to be a little bit different, specifically because the campaign is locked, zombies is locked, and even multiplayer is locked as of right now, just a few days away from launch. But anywho, that is it. That is everything I wanted to talk about here in this video today. Short and sweet and to the point. Let me know what you think about these modes being locked. Honestly, I think it's fair. I think it makes sense. And I'm really hoping they do this all the way up to the global release. I know that the servers are going to have to go online at some point, which will allow people to play multiplayer a little bit early. Part of me does feel some type of way, though, because normally we see a lot of leaks, which gets me hyped in its own sense. I know that there will still be leaks, especially when that preload goes live on PC, but either way, I'm happy, I'm excited, and the game is only a couple of days away. So let me know what y'all think about it down below in the comments section. I hope y'all enjoyed this conversation we had today. If you did, do me a favor, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more videos coming very soon. And of course, if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Catch y'all in the next one. Peace.